What distinguishes the study of myth at Pacifica is that it is truly unique. There's really no other program like it in the world. And that's because it's interdisciplinary, but also bringing in a number of other important perspectives, whether it be from art history, from feminism, from anthropology, gender studies. And we weave it all together in a way that I think is incredibly fresh and coherent. Hillman pointed out that we need a therapy of ideas and a therapy of culture, as well as attending to the wounds of an individual psyche. So in this program, which is an interdisciplinary humanities program, we're looking at how we can understand not only our own self, our own self-understanding, but how our culture functions.
The myth program at Pacifica is in many ways a very traditional Ph.D. program. It keeps the energy going during the day is the multidisciplinary approach and the multicultural dimension. And probably most importantly in all is that direct personal engagement of the energies of the images in the texts. Joseph Campbell is relates to the myth program as a kind of foundational figure that goes back to its origins before Pacifica was Pacifica. And what I think was really unique about him was that he didn't just give you the information. What you got from him was a direct experience of those things.
What makes myth an important field of study in the contemporary world is the way in which it bridges antiquity, the medieval period of history, the modern world, and this very strange unfolding postmodern world. People come and spend 3 days together, you know, once per month, in what's almost a retreat-like atmosphere. Students bond very quickly, and the atmosphere is very collegial.
A whole dimension of the imagination opens up, and it's charged with spiritual energy, intellectual energy. It's what has given me a sense of meaning and direction and a passion, because I can share those things with others.
You know, graduates from our program emerge with more robust, exciting lives. Since we attract a lot of artists, we have people who use the degree in their artwork, whether that's painting or creative writing. We have people who work in the field of organizational development and the therapeutic field. But in addition to that, people take the degree back into the professions they already have, which includes law, medicine, and business.
It's an endangered activity having to do with anything having to do with the humanities. So what they're getting is a fantastic education, and many of them are coming to it hungry for that education in the liberal arts because they missed it.
A fresh look at how to understand people, how to understand the culture, and how to thrive. It gives people a greater sense of who they are, what they value, and what they can offer the world.